Hey guys, Mr. Walker here again, and welcome to another math lesson with yours truly. We're going to be keeping this lesson kind of super short today, or at least a little bit shorter, because we're building upon what we did yesterday as far as making equivalent fractions using multiplication, okay? So we're going to do a little bit more of that, but I feel like you guys have a pretty good idea of how to do that already. We're just going to look at some different scenarios to see what happens if some different things come up every once in a while. So just make sure you have something to write on, something to write with, and we'll get started. We'll run through a couple examples, and then you guys will be on your own to practice, okay? So first of all, starting off, we talked yesterday about if we had a fraction, let's say 1/3, and we multiplied our numerator and our denominator by the same number, we would get an equivalent fraction. So 1 times 2 would be 2, 3 times 2 would be 6, right? And we reasoned this is true because when we were using the area model, right, to kind of illustrate this, if I had thirds to start, and I had 1/3, right, 1/3, and then I made twice as many units, or I divided it here and decomposed it into 2, I would have 6 pieces, and 2 of them would be colored in. So we know if we multiply by the same number, we're going to make an equivalent fraction, and we reasoned using the area model, we reasoned to say that, yeah, that's going to be true. So most of the examples we looked at yesterday had a 1 in the numerator. So today, we're going to do the same sort of things we did yesterday, but we're going to look at fractions that have different numerators and just some different examples. So let's see. If I gave you, let's say, a fraction like 5/6, if I multiply both of my numerator and my denominator by 2, I would get, well, 5 times 2 is 10, 6 times 2 is 12, right? So I would have 10/12. So let's just real quick draw an area model to make sure that this holds true even if our numerator isn't 1. So I'm going to go ahead, I divided this whole into 6 pieces. I'm going to color in 5 of them. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So I have 5/6, and then we multiply by 2, so we double, right? So I'm going to double this by splitting it here. And now I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 10 of them are colored in. So now I have 10/12. So yes, no matter what our numerator and denominator are, if we multiply them by the same number, we're going to make an equivalent fraction. So let's try a little bit of problem solving now with this new skill that we have. If I had 3/4 and I had 6/8, could we tell if they are equivalent fractions without having to draw out area models and do all that kind of stuff? Could we tell if they are actually the same amount, just different numbers? Yeah, we could, and here's how. We could think, is there a number, any number, that I can multiply both my numerator and denominator by to get to 6/8? Can I multiply 3 times something to get 6 and 4 times that same something to get 8? Well, let's figure this out. Well, I'd want to start with 1. 3 times 1 wouldn't be 6, it would be 3. So that's not going to work. What about 2? 3 times 2 would give me 6, right? 4 times 2 would give me 8. So there we go. So these are equivalent fractions because I was able to multiply by the same number, both my numerator and denominator, by the same number to get that other fraction. What about if I had, well, let's say, yes, this guy checks out. What about if I had 3/4 and 6/12, are they equivalent fractions? No, they're not. You might think, okay, well, yeah, 3 times 2 is 6, but if I did 4 times 2, I'm going to get 8. I would have to do 4 times 3 to get 12, and if I did 3 times 3, that would give me 9. So these guys are not equal. So it's another quick way you can look to see if fractions are equivalent. All right, last step here. I'm going to give you guys a fraction. Let's say 3/5, and I want you to give me an equivalent fraction. Mean equivalent fraction, and then I think we're good for practicing this for today. All right, awesome. There's a ton of equivalent fractions I can make. If I multiplied my numerator and denominator by 2, I would get 6/10, right? 6/10 looks good. I could multiply my numerator and denominator times 3 to get 9/15. I could do by 4, I could do by 5, by 6, I could go on and on and on. Don't want to, because you don't want to sit here and just watch me multiply things for the rest of the afternoon. So I think you guys are getting the concept. You're going to practice this some more today. I'll put another video after this one with some like additional kind of practice stuff if you guys want to check that out, if you need some extra support. But again, you guys are getting the hang of this pretty quick. You're doing some great work. Keep it up. Let me know if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, and I appreciate you guys for watching. All right, talk to you soon.